Hi, this is Cameron Blagan, and this is week two of the Better Business Bureau exploration I'm doing, especially for young consumers. I'm super excited to be talking to you guys this week about generally what the Better Business Bureau is, business accreditation, and complaint handling. So these things might seem kind of mundane, or you've already heard about it before, but I really learned some interesting things, especially from my perspective, that I think you guys will find very interesting as consumers, and if you're a business owner as well. So let's jump right in. So first of all, a lot of people don't know what is the Better Business Bureau. The Better Business Bureau can be summed up in one concise vision, which the Better Business Bureau on their website says is an ethical marketplace where buyers and sellers trust each other. So what does that even mean? This means that the Better Business Bureau is trying to create a place and an atmosphere, a marketplace where you can order something either in person or online, and you don't have to worry about if that's a business you can trust. The Better Business Bureau's missions are active goals that they have set in place to fulfill that vision they have of that marketplace, ethical marketplace. So a few of those missions, again, as listed on their website, are to be a leader in advancing marketplace trust. And they do this by setting standards for that marketplace trust, encouraging and supporting best practices, and by engaging with and educating consumers and businesses about what's going on in the marketplace, any scams, and we'll get into that in a few weeks. Celebrating marketplace models. If there's a business out there who's just killing it and they have just a great ethical standard and they've been treating their customers amazing, they want to highlight that and celebrate that. On the other end of things, they call out and address substandard marketplace behavior. So if a business is not performing well, they want to highlight that and alert consumers so that they don't get scammed or ripped off as well. They also want to create a community of trustworthy businesses and charities. The charities part a lot of people don't know about, and that's really cool. So they, again, are fostering this community of businesses and charities that they have reached out to, contacted, and accredited so that we as consumers and them as businesses can have this trust and ethical communication and interaction in the marketplace. Better Business Bureau sees this trust as two main factors. So first, before I get into those, here's a little history of where the Better Business Bureau came from. So in the 1800s and early 1900s, there's no regulations for ads, which you can imagine would be a nightmare. Businesses could make crazy claims about anything and everything. So then Coca-Cola manager at the time, Samuel Dobbs, was really bothered by this and gave many public addresses on honest advertising, the importance of that. He then connected with others who shared his concern, and in 1912, these group of business owners, civic leaders, and university professors created the group which eventually became the Better Business Bureau. They investigated untruthful advertisements, and that is where the Better Business Bureau group was eventually formed. Fast forward to today, and the Better Business Bureau is still doing things like that. In addition to investigating honest advertising, they do many other services, like I said, that I'll be explaining throughout these few weeks. The Better Business Bureau mainly bases how they accredit businesses on two things: integrity and performance. Integrity includes things like respect, ethics, and the good intent. And performance includes things such as the business's track records of delivering good results in accordance with the BBB standards and addressing customer concerns and reviews in a timely and satisfactory manner. In a nutshell, Better Business Bureau accreditation is a community of businesses who have signed a pledge saying that they promise to uphold Better Business Bureau's standards of business and business practices, to be ethical and have integrity, and to just do the right thing in general. The Better Business Bureau is a nonprofit organization that aids consumers by supplying free public reporting services to the community, as well as accrediting businesses, which helps both the businesses and consumers know that they can be in a trustworthy interaction. This accreditation, and the Better Business Bureau in general, helps protect people from getting ripped off and help businesses be better. So how does the BBB do it? Here's a few requirements for the business to be accredited. You have to be in business for at least 6 months. That's enough time to allow the BBB to figure out if there is a negative or positive track record forming in their interaction with their customers. They must have all licensing, insurance, certifications, and anything else required for your business to be legal. This means you as the consumer, if you see that little sticker on a door or wherever you're doing business, means that you can rest assured that this business is performing legally and has all the proper qualifications to be giving you their services. In addition to all these requirements and being a certified company, they must also have at least a B rating with the Better Business Bureau accreditation. This is determined by many factors that I already talked about, as well as a few others, which really just make sure that the Better Business Bureau is doing their job in making sure that this business will perform for you, rather than just giving them a sticker for paying a fee. They're actually making sure that they're performing well enough to be treating their customers how the Better Business Bureau would expect an accredited business to. One of the best and most helpful parts of the accreditation process is that each company is hand vetted. That means only companies who genuinely care and put their best foot forward can be selected by the Better Business Bureau to be accredited. this is just another factor that helps us as consumers rest assured that these businesses are really going to perform for us, and if there's any problems, it will be taken care of, and they're even more unlikely to arise because they were hand-vetted by the Better Business Bureau, and they made sure that they uphold their integrity and performance. So how can this help you as the consumer, and if you're a business owner, your business? Well, the Better Business Bureau looks at customer complaints and reviews and requires that the businesses respond to the complaints and suggests they respond to the reviews. I'll talk more on this later. Customer reviews are also super important, and I'll talk about this in a later week, but they're verified reviews, which in today's world of many unverified fake reviews, that is a huge thing, a huge service that the Better Business Bureau offers. This can help businesses to better respond to customers and customers better choose a business. Another big part that the Better Business Bureau plays in making sure that businesses are safe and ethical is checking government records. This is very important to you as a consumer because you wouldn't want to be giving your services to a company who could potentially be sued for some illegal action that they had with a previous customer. Going back to the roots of why the Better Business Bureau was created, it also checks that businesses' advertising is clear and ethical. The Better Business Bureau also checks how businesses are protecting your privacy as the consumer. This is important to you as a consumer because in a world where online information is more and more ubiquitous, it's increasingly important that our personal information isn't put out on a website by a company, either intentionally or unintentionally, because that could lead to identity theft, which we'll talk about in a few weeks. Overall, this helps customers know which businesses are safe, ethical, and go above and beyond to make sure that they're serving their customers the best they can. It helps businesses by showing your customers that you're ethical and trustworthy. You'll also show up in Better Business Bureau directory searches, which we'll talk about in a few weeks, which is both awesome for the consumer and the business. All in all, this helps the marketplace stay safe and reliable. This means customers are more likely to use businesses' services, and customers are less likely to get ripped off by businesses. The Better Business Bureau's hope is that this accreditation will help consumers and businesses stay safer and be more likely to use the accredited businesses because of their hand-vetted safety and ethical integrity. In a world of increasingly unethical and online businesses, it is more important than ever to be an accredited business and to use those businesses who have promised to do the right thing. It's the Better Business Bureau way, and they're here to help you find a safe business. To finish off this episode, I'm just going to talk quickly about complaint handling. This is a huge part of the Better Business Bureau that I didn't know about before even looking into it. The Better Business Bureau's goal is to help businesses and consumers resolve issues without having to have a negative or legal way of carrying out this negative interaction. On the consumer side, you follow a link on their website to file a complaint. Everything you submit is forwarded to the business within 2 business days. Businesses must respond within 14 days, and the Better Business Bureau will send a second request if they haven't sent a response by then. You, or whoever lodged the complaint, will receive the business's response when they send it. Complaint cases are usually closed within 30 days, and it's the Better Business Bureau's hope that it would be a positive outcome and help you to not have a negative interaction with this business. On the business side, it helps you get better reviews by properly responding to a customer before it becomes a negative review. This helps customers have trust in the fact that they can get help from you at any time and that you are there if anything goes wrong. This is huge, especially in being an ethical and trustworthy business. This is better and different than classic review systems because it can affect Better Business Bureau accreditation scores, which can help consumers know if businesses are properly handling complaints, which are bound to arise in any business. It also requires a business response, which is different than a review where your negative response could just sit on the internet for anyone to see, and the business doesn't have to do anything about it. These are also better because they allow and require a customer business response, which makes for a quick and easy resolution to almost any problem. This has obvious benefits for the customer and the business and fits so well into what the Better Business Bureau's goal is for a safe, ethical, trustworthy, and reliable marketplace. Feel free to contact a Better Business Bureau representative or comment on this video if you have any questions about what the Better Business Bureau does or what it can do for you. I'll see you guys next week with some real life stories on how the Better Business Bureau has actually helped some real businesses and customers across the country. I can't wait to keep discovering things for you guys each week, and I'll see you again in another video. Thanks!